I became a mother really young, so it's almost hard to remember. We had just gotten married, and then I was pregnant pretty much right away. We got sent home with Inara, you know, perfect, easy delivery, all of that. The moment we got home, I remember we were really excited, and I was still kind of riding the high, I think, of giving birth. So we actually invited everybody we knew to come over and see this newborn baby. And then I realized once they all went home and my husband went to bed that now it's just me and the baby, and the exhaustion started to hit. Every time the baby cried, like, I felt very guilty. I just kind of felt like everything was going wrong and I didn't have the energy or the enthusiasm to try to deal with any of it. So I would say, like, I started to experience kind of that postpartum blues very early on, like, you know, within 24 hours of being home with the baby, kind of just as soon as everyone left our house.
Most of the women in our lives will experience postpartum blues. Data shows that up to 80% of women will experience, like, mood changes, periods of crying, fluctuations in anxiety that start within a few days of giving birth and can last for up to 2 weeks. As of right now, there are actually no approved interventions for postpartum blues. We know that the prevalence for postpartum depression is around 13% of women. Unfortunately, though, for individuals who've experienced postpartum blues, their risk of developing postpartum depression later on is about 4 times what their risk would be typically.
I specialize in using a form of brain imaging with the intent of developing studies and findings to try to either prevent or treat mental illness. Because I noticed as a psychiatrist that many women, unfortunately, their first depressions in postpartum. And at the same time, I was using an imaging technique to look at a special protein called MAOA, which I knew was influenced by drops in estrogen. On day 5 postpartum, there's an elevation in an important brain protein that's involved in doing the opposite of an antioxidant, and it also removes brain chemicals. I invented a supplement to counter this change in the brain protein around the same time. We did a study in which just over 100 women completed. And what we found was that the supplement reduced the severity of postpartum blues that can happen in the first few days postpartum, peaking around day 5. The study also found that 3 to 6 months later, the severity of depression symptoms was much lower in the women who got the active supplement. It consists of antioxidant, it consists also of nutritional ingredients that become brain chemicals that support a normal, healthy kind of mood.
This natural supplement, when it comes to Canada, will give women a chance to intervene early and to hopefully prevent future depressive episodes, which will allow women to stay well and stay with their families.
If I had known that 8 out of 10 people experienced this, I would have felt so much relief and it would have taken a lot of the guilt away. Just knowing that CAMH has developed this, I can imagine when my 8-year-old is an adult and if she chooses to have children, then she wouldn't face any of that dark road that I went through. And I really hope it's an opportunity for more conversation about postpartum blues and maternal mental health, and that it becomes a tool in the toolbox alongside other things.